The salvation of Nigerians from Nigerian political class is still far. The video you just watched is a proof of it. If Edo people could troop out en masse to shear up their very oppressors this way, then there is almost no hope for an average Nigerian. Yes, if you're still wondering whom we are talking about, I watch this one closely. Adamo Somole, you heard them hail him, shouting with joy, welcoming and campaigning for their very oppressors. Now, let me remind you, Edo people, and the rest of Nigerians, because this is the same attitude of an average Nigerians towards their oppressors. If Edo people can believe and come out en masse like this, whether they were bought, whether they were hired, whether they were, no matter which way, what you saw there, eh? If the Edo people can do this and believe in the same man, an old man without honor, who speaks from both sides of his mouth. This is not the first time I'm doing this. This is not the first time I'm saying this. This is not the first time you'll be seeing this video, where he say one thing today and say a direct opposite tomorrow. Adamo Somole, the previous election, said this about the same man he's campaigning today, whom these people you are looking at are coming up to share up.
A loser, 700 million. You are a loser, 700 million. You are a loser. EFCC waiting for you. One more time. 700 million. You are a loser. Pastor, you are a loser. Izeyamu, you are a loser. EFCC waiting for you.
For me, it's over. Those who are contesting today, I saw them now. I shouldn't say it loud. But when you are moving from EFCC cell to campaign table, from campaign tray to EFCC cell, to a courtroom, to a bail, Abba, Edo people, we be mumu?
No!
We be mumu?
No!
When I go move on best way, man, that they call?
No! Criminal!
Best way for bail, when I go move on, huh?
No! When I see him.
Now I'm going to talk about Izeyamu. I talk to you how he went to school. So I'm also obliged to report as follows, and we are liable if we say anything that is libelous. I bear full responsibility in my personal capacity. I waive my immunity. I set my immunity aside, and I declare as follows before God that the other guy, Mr. Izeyamu, he has a very interesting lifestyle. He went to school. He finished his primary school. I haven't seen the testimony, but he finished. He then went to University of Benin to read law. 2 years later, he was rusticated. For 2 years, they drive him from school. Why? He carried acid and pour on the body of another student. Today, that student is deformed for life. His manhood has been destroyed. Today, he cannot raise a family. That is his credentials. And that is why he could not go to law school. That is why, although he read law, he is not a barrister. Now, because of crisis of identity, he went to carry a Bible and said he's a pastor. I'm born again. I'm born. It's okay. The sin is committed. He has to continue to pray for that. Then, somehow he got out of Uniben, not a barrister. He has to carry pastor. All right. But you remember Pastor King? Pastor King. How many people King? He sentenced to death. Now, so to carry Bible, he doesn't give a clue about who you are. Only God knows who is a Christian.
With the same mouth, he said this. With that same mouth, he is campaigning and people are clapping for them. APC, Association of Past Criminals, they have proven that beyond every reasonable doubt. The man, when he be say 700 million naira scam or corrupt practice is still hanging on his neck, is the same man APC had handed over their flag to run for governorship in Edo State.
Good morning, my friends.
Good morning.
Honest people in Nigeria.
Now you collect it.
Excellent. Thank you, everybody.
Now, what do you expect if he goes into power? The same thing you have been witnessing. Now, this does not exonerate the PDP, because some of you will think that it is about my hatred for APC. No, it is the fact, it is the truth of the matter that Nigerian political, it doesn't matter what political party they belong to, they are two sides of the same coin. That is why you have not witnessed a reasonable and appreciable progress in Nigeria, in the lives of Nigerians. Check it. The story is ever the same. But I am here to remind you, maybe we'll continue doing this. I'm almost giving up on Nigerians because it seems their matter not going to end today. Hold it there. I know my Biafran people who are watching, we say, didn't I tell you, talking about Nigerian politics, it is not going to work. Yes, it is not working. Yes, I'm not talking about Nigerian politics. I'm talking about the freedom of Nigerians from Nigeria, which Biafrans are part of. So keep that opinion to yourself. We are all in this mess together. It doesn't matter whether you are Oduduwa, Arewa, or Biafra. As long as you find yourself within this British colonial contraption called Nigeria, we are all feeling the pain. We are all victims of this system. And until we free ourselves from the clutches of this political, let me not use the kind of word I want to use now, but you know them and what they have done to your lives. Until we free ourselves from them. They are your brothers, the Oduduwas. They are your brothers, the Arawas. They are part of you, the Biafrans. Those that had made your life miserable. But what do? You clap for them. We are warming up in Anambra State. Very soon, they are already drumming up. Anambra State, I must say it with pride. They are the best when it comes to politics and democratic and dispensation in terms of how to play it in Nigeria. They are the best. I can give it to them. All right? But the truth of the matter is that this whole thing is still happening. Tell me what has gotten better in your life as a Nigerian. It doesn't matter where you come from. But you see the number of people that came out. Now, if you call for the people, for the same suffering people of Nigeria, the very victims of Nigeria, if we call them to come out en masse and make a demand to fix their schools, you will not see them. And make a demand to fix their hospitals, you will not see them. And make a demand so that their youths, after they have graduated, they will have jobs to do. You will not see them. Rather, you see them watching frivolities on social media and on TVs, making jokes of their miserable lives. If you call them to stand up and say enough is enough, because this man, if you know the amount of money these guys plunder, you will not be doing what you are doing now. In fact, everywhere will be turned upside down. But to Nigerians, they are not interested. But we must continue until this message sinks. We must continue until this message sinks. Those of you who have gone to church, welcome back. What did you hear? What value did it add to you today? Did your preachers tell you that your problems are these people that you come to drum support for? Did they tell you that? Did they tell you that the marauders who are going about ransacking your villages, killing people, raping women, kidnapping, destroying your farmlands, you can no longer access your farmlands anymore? Did they tell you in church today to come out and say enough is enough and join the 1 million march? Did you hear from them today? Did you hear from them that the politicians, your governors, your legislators or legislators, as they call them, refuse to sign into law anti-open grazing bill, which will enable you to start accessing your farmlands again, which will enable your farmers, your women, to go to farm without being raped and killed? Did they tell you that in church today? No, they didn't. But we will tell you that here on this platform. And that is why I'll keep telling you, here we know the look face. We say it the way it is. I know the world hates truth. Yes, truth is very expensive. Very few trade with it. If you lies, falsehood, hyping, very cheap. Everybody can afford it. But here, we trade with the truth. And we'll keep on with that truth until that truth is able to break you loose and set you free. Beginning from here. I've spoken enough. Nigerian people. In Nigeria, did I forget to tell you that your president's wife, not vice president, your president's wife, Aisha Buhari, was flown to Dubai for just neck pain. Ordinary neck pain. They cannot treat in Nigeria. And you believe that you have a future in this country. Sorry for you. It is high time you join this revolution. We are still on the mental revolution, which will ignite the proper revolution that will shut down this system. Then everybody will now go back home and think, are we going to remain like this? Or are we going to say to your tent, O Israel, every trace of colonial establishment, every product of colonization, which Nigeria is number one epitome of it, will be dismantled. That is the only time Africans will begin to breathe. I'm signing out. If this is your first time of being on this platform, welcome. This is BVI Channel 1, where we tell you the truth, the way it is. And I still remain your voice, the voice of the people, the voice of God, and the voice of our ancestors. Keep subscribing, keep liking, keep sharing. Don't forget, drop your comment. Let the discussion continue. I'm signing out.